Today, we're going to walk through how to make your own content engine using your writing as examples in any input you want to create a blurb, a description for a website, anything digital, right inside a spreadsheet. So this is going to use, we're going to be using the tool PromptLoop, which uses AI models to generate text that looks and feels and sounds like your voice. So this is not a one-click AI writing tool. This is a way where you can start to draft better performing copy. We're going to take battle-tested product descriptions from a huge e-commerce site, and we're going to show how we can reverse engineer that, take what's already working, what's already ranking, and turn that into the inputs for this specific engine. Everything's going to be linked below. PromptLoop is a paid tool, so this is geared at professionals, but anyone can use it, and we do have a free trial to get started right now. So tune in. So let's jump over. What we're looking at is a Google Sheet. This will be linked below, but basically it's a template. You can change the colors, change the text, design this any way you want it. The point of spreadsheets is obviously get me what I want, keep it organized, keep the data in one place. And that's exactly why we're using the tool right now. It's not Google Docs. It's maybe not the writing tool you think of, but you'll understand a little bit why it works so well as a spreadsheet tool. You can see we have some headers, product, value prop, call to action, and generation. PromptLoop, the tool we're using, is a Google Sheets extension. You can see I'm activating it in the dropdown, and there'll be links below. It is a big part of what we're doing here, so you do need this. Although you can use this framework to think about content in general. In this case, we're going to be looking at e-commerce. So e-commerce store owners, digital consultants are spending a lot of time thinking about the best way to talk about my product to the customers. A lot of that is testing what they want to hear about, looking at what products are already selling well, what are customers saying about those products, using their language, using your language to talk about each piece. So Valentine's Day is coming up. Let's look at Tiffany as an example of a company, an amazing 100 plus year brand, maybe the most well-known color in all of marketing, and certainly a company that's trying to sell some very high value items in the next 2 weeks. So what I'm going to do is take three pieces of their product descriptions, and we're going to reverse engineer them. They have professional writers. They've tested what works for their customers, so it's already working. All we're going to do is we're going to take three products, and we're going to pull out the important pieces of context for those products, like the product name, the brand, and what we want someone to do. In this case, it's probably a call to action, like a click. So we're going to go to the website, and I've already pulled up a couple. Let me just take this product description and then go over here. See, all I'm doing is taking, cutting and pasting. We'll do gifts, some of their classics. And that is definitely a word they probably use a lot. When you think of Tiffany and brands like this, you do think of classics. So nothing fancy. I'm just going to take these three. So I'm also picking a variety. I don't want all of these to be about necklaces unless we're only writing content for necklaces. I took three different styles, three different brands. But this is examples we're going to feed into the model to tell it what we're looking for. If I was selling NFL jerseys, if I was selling or describing a particular business's service offering, this column is going to be replaced for what your ideal case scenario is. This could be things that you've gotten from your content generator before, things you've written, things your competitors have written, but the context and writing style is what's going to get picked up by the model. So then we're going to go through each of these and pull out the context. So here, the product name is important. Grammarly's suggesting changes here. So the Tiffany T collection wire bracelet is the product. I'm just gonna pull that out. Great. So inspired where it came from, silver bracelet, arrow-shaped toggle. I'm just gonna pull out the context, like in your future products, which we're gonna get to. What are the types of things that are most important? We're reverse engineering. You likely have this somewhere. Obviously, I'm pulling this from their website, so we're doing it from scratch, but it just shows you this is gonna take about 2 minutes, and all of a sudden I have a customized model content engine that can get us exactly what we want. So the value prop, I'm actually going to change value prop. So this is just like a piece of our model training inputs. I'm going to change value prop to, maybe value prop's appropriate. Value prop is timeless design pairs with collection. So the model's going to understand, okay, there's a relationship. We want to talk about timeless design. Here's an example of how we did it. So that when we feed that into future inputs, that's what it's going to do. So inspired, legacy, and pairs with heart tag line. I'm just using plain English. Could do it in other languages too, but for the sake of this demo, look for both day and night. New York City look, evenings. and then the call to action. There actually isn't a call to action. I'm just going to remove this column. If this was like a piece of marketing content outside of e-commerce, this might be relevant, but that's like a good idea. We could also have something like price or gender or any product attribute that's relevant for a clothing brand, for example. So now that we have these three things, we're just going to jump over to our dropdown data. So one, now that we have three good examples, we can basically generate a similar piece of copy for any product we can imagine. So I'm just going to make up a few. So the Tiffany-Nike collab came out. Our model doesn't know the details of this. This isn't going on the internet to Google it, but we can let it get creative for and just describe what it is. Get Nike performance and Tiffany blue style. Get that out. We'll delete this. Or we'll just leave it blank. So then that's one, and the other one is going to be metal men's necklace. And the value prop is look amazing at the gym. This is where you'd put, maybe you'd cut and paste all of the products you want to work for. There could be hundreds, there could be 10. I'm doing two. And now we're pretty much ready to go. We have our examples, we have our dropdown data, and then back on here, we have our inputs. So these are pre-configured. So now all we need to do to get this to work is select the sneakers, select Nike Performance. Obviously these two match up, so they could really be combined, but we're imagining we could mix and match. You can guess at other examples of what to put into the value prop dropdown that you might want to speak to differently in different contexts, different customers. And then we're just going to select yes on generate. And now PromptLoop is going to go to these three examples, go to the dropdown or go to what we selected in the dropdown and pull together a piece of content that's going to match the length, style, everything of our examples. But in this case, it's talking about the Tiffany Nike collab. So I think that's pretty cool. This is just a very simple way, inspired by a lot of what teams are already using PromptLoop for, to get started with. Hope you found this was enjoyable. We'll include a couple other examples of outside of e-commerce, how this can be really useful. And again, all links are below. Please like and subscribe to this channel. We'll do more of these and look forward to doing some live soon. Thanks.